Hybrid closed-loop systems are the newest developments in diabetes care. And the advantage of the systems are that if your blood sugar is high, the system can give you a little bit more insulin. If your blood sugar is low, the system can suspend the insulin delivery or decrease the insulin delivery, so it can prevent the hypoglycemia. The only available hybrid closed-loop system in the United States right now is the Medtronic 670G. This is the first generation of the hybrid closed-loop system. And at Barbara Davis Center at University of Colorado in Denver, and we have the highest population of using the systems. And we conducted a study with 127 patients that have been using any pump and with a CGM system at least 3 months. And after the initiation of the 670G system, and we followed them for 6 months, and we looked at the glycemic measures at the 3 months and 6 months. And we saw that the hypoglycemia rate decreased about 30%, and also hyperglycemia decreased about 27%. Time in range, what we consider between the blood sugar 70 to 180 milligram deciliter, increased about 18% and reaching the 70%. And all the glycemic metrics were positively correlated with the automode use. Another advantage of this system is we saw in this study that there was no weight gain at the 6 months. The current limitations of the hybrid closed-loop systems that they are not a fully closed-loop. So patient's input is also very important. The system requires when the patients are eating and also doing exercises. The patient needs to adjust the insulin dose delivery based on their exercise and also based on their food, they still need to give boluses. And to overcome this problems in the hybrid closed-loop systems, we need some next-generation systems that has more adaptable for the exercise and meal boluses. And also keeping a close relationship with the providers, having realistic expectations and having some realistic targets are the best way to overcome the obstacles with the systems. Immune checkpoint inhibitors are the revolutionary treatment options in advanced cancers, and the recent Nobel Award was awarded for the invention of these medications, and they are great and they increase the lifespan in the advanced cancers. But on the other hand, these medications has some side effects. By doing that, and they are immune checkpoint inhibitors attack the cancer cells, and by using our own immune cells, unfortunately, they also attack our own cells too. And these are called autoimmune side effects. And type 1 diabetes is a rare but life-threatening side effect of these medications. And we conducted a study of the 71 cases so far all reported. And we wanted to see what's the relationship with this diabetes duration to onset and what are the other risk factors. And we showed that the type 1 diabetes associated antibodies and that there is a correlation between type 1 diabetes associated antibodies and duration to onset of diabetes. And if somebody has at the beginning, at the presentation of the diabetes, has type 1 diabetes associated antibodies, and their duration to onset to diabetes is shorter. And we also show that if you have HLA genes that are risk groups such as DR3 and DR4, and you also have an increased risk for to develop type 1 diabetes. And diabetic ketoacidosis risk at presentation with these medications is also higher if you have type 1 diabetes associated antibodies. We believe that the patients already has autoimmune problems are under risk for to develop other autoimmune problems with the immune checkpoint inhibitors. And we don't know if these patients are changing to type 1 diabetes associated antibodies after the initiation of the medication, or some of these patients have already have type 1 diabetes associated antibodies before initiation of treatment. Our hypothesis is some of the patients that develop type 1 diabetes have already LADA, which means that latent autoimmune diabetes. So they already has this type 1 diabetes associated antibodies, and after the trigger of this immune checkpoint inhibitors, they develop a full-blown type 1 diabetes, which is irreversible.